Aren't you a little bit curious how well the bees are doing with that sugar feed that I gave them the other day? I am, so we're gonna walk back, maybe put a little extra feed in. We'll see how they're doing. Hey, Maggie. How you doing, sweetie? Yes. No time for horses. I could have said no time for horsing around. Here we're rounding the corner into this area that will be the new apiary. All this empty space right here. This is where the beehives are going to go probably in a couple weeks. I don't have any smoke today. I'm just coming in suited up with gloves. I don't expect a whole lot of trouble because I'm just going to get into the top of this hive and check out to see how those feeders are doing. And it looks like they have drank down, you know, pretty close. The ones closer to the entrance makes sense that they're lower. This one's a little past halfway. This one's not quite halfway or maybe right at. And then a little more on the ends. We're just going to get these bees off here, open them up, and fill up a little bit. Just kind of cap them off. Now, one of my viewers in the comments, I don't know who it is because I didn't commit the name to memory right then, but somebody mentioned that it's the vacuum more than surface tension that's holding this in, because I had mentioned in my previous video that the water tension, the surface tension, was going to be holding the water in, but they pointed out that it's the vacuum in the top of the jar that's going to keep the water mostly in, and I think they're correct. I just mentioned water tension at the time because that's what I had in my brain, just what I was thinking, just how I was wrong. I had this container of sugar water sitting on the kitchen counter. And Mama Kerbs, my wife, asked me several times, "So what's the plan? What are you doing? Are you gonna go fill those up, or what? How are you gonna use that jug of water?" I don't think she was especially concerned about the bees. It was really just me leaving stuff on the counter. I need to be better about that. Well, I didn't bring enough to fill all of them up. This one is still a little bit low, but just gives them a little extra food, a little extra something to enjoy so they can establish this hive a little easier. Now, there's no need to go into the hive at this point. They were fine when I went in just, what was it, 5 days ago. So I'm just gonna cap it off here, put the lid on, and let them have a nice day. Although I think I am going to go ahead and get into hive number 4 because I'm curious. I didn't get in there the other day, so I'm just kind of curious what they look like. I didn't bring any tools, but hopefully it's not stuck together too much. And the camera right now is sitting on top of hive number 6 and I'm talking, so I do expect a few bees to come out and see what's going on here in just a moment. Hive number 6 is my more aggressive hive. Ooh. Looks like they did have the inner cover stuck on pretty well. I am gonna have to get my tool out here at some point and break that loose. According to a local beekeeper, a friend of mine, in fact you may know him, Mr. Mark, he was the lead beekeeper on that log extraction video, he told me that the small hive beetle problem isn't really a problem in a fall. Most of his hives don't have beetles right now. It's the end of the season and they're not really going strong. So I do have a few dead beetles in these towel traps, but I think he's right. For the most part, the beetles aren't a big issue at this time of year. And here's hive number four. They look pretty strong. They have pollen. You can see pollen on their legs there. There's plenty of bees. There are some dead beetles in the towel trap. They seem pretty calm. I see a lot of honey in there. That's a really fast inspection of a hive. I'm not actually even getting in to see what's going on too much. I just wanted to see that there were still bees and that they appeared to be okay. And really they do. The hive looks really calm, really full of bees and lots of honey and no beetles. I don't see any wax moth, you know, the webbing that they form. Or yeah, it looks pretty good right now. I'm really hoping to get all three of these hives through the winter. Put this on slowly so I'm not squashing bees. I think some of our friends from hive number six are starting to come out. You can see them on the camera. You can hear them up in the microphone and they're buzzing all around me. Hive number six, well, I think they're too strong to perish over the winter. They should be fine. Let me show you what the entrance to hive number six looks like. And that's it. I'm walking away. That's all we have for today. Just a little update, checking out the sugar water in hive number three. That's what we're calling hive three. The reason they're numbered, just so you know, let me give you a little perspective. I did tell you at the beginning of this video that the apiary is going to move, the bee yard is going to move. But for now, the way that it has been, am I still on? Ah, yeah. The way that it has been is this. Now, I do have some bee equipment out in the yard that probably shouldn't be here right now, so don't judge me too harshly. But let me turn around and show you the apiary. This is the position. There's hive one, then there was a two, three, then over here, four, and then there was a five in the middle, which just recently disappeared, and six. That's why I call them hives one, two, three, four, five, six. And over here, give you a little better perspective, right down this pathway over here to check out the soon-to-be bee yard. This opening, this clearing right here. This right here is a nice big opening, clearing. We have the eastern sun comes up over here, comes over and sets over here. None of these trees are terribly, terribly tall to cast a shadow in the middle of this here. So the hives will be positioned right out here. The fence will come out over here, give me plenty of room to work. And yeah, I think that's gonna be a pretty nice place for a new apiary, and I'm pretty excited about it. I got distracted by a butterfly. Let me see if I can show you. Well, there you go. Sugar, oh man, I forgot that pitcher. Mama Kerbs did want this out of the kitchen, but I'm pretty sure she didn't want me to leave it out in the yard. If you like this video, please share it. If you would like to join a community where we all share thoughts and pictures and stories, join the Daddykirbs Fanily, F-A-N-I-L-Y, Facebook group. That link will be below. Also, if you're interested in a Daddykirbs hat, such as this one, you can contact me through my blog site, daddykirbs.com. Send me a message through the contact form. Someday, I'll have an official hat page where people can see it and order them. But for now, if you just send me a message, we'll coordinate getting one sent in the mail. I do hope to do some contest in the future where the hats will be the subject in a selfie. That'll be you with the hat in front of some interesting location on social media, your favorite social media, and you can hashtag it DaddyKirbsFanily, F-A-N-I-L-Y, and we're going to do a contest with that eventually. Hey, Maggie. Thanks for hanging out with me in this episode of Daddykirbs Beekeeping. I'll talk to you soon.